Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman and members of the Transportation and Infrastructure Committee. Thank you all so much for allowing me to be a part of this process, and I'm very honored and pleased to appear before you today. My name is Sandra D. Norman. I'm Division Administrator for Civil Rights for the Virginia Department of Transportation. As director, I know firsthand of the DBE's program's importance that is within your jurisdiction. I'm very supportive of the DBE program that assists minority and women-owned businesses who are ready, willing, and able to compete and perform contract work as either a prime contractor or a subcontractor. I believe it is the right thing to do. It continues to drive equality and inclusiveness. The DBE program for the United States meets constitutional tests. Every court has held that the DBE program regulations at 49 CFR Part 26 are constitutional. Why is the DBE program important? Here are some of my thoughts for you to consider. The DBE program has its roots in the Civil Rights Act of 1964. It has been regulated through a series of reauthorization legislative initiatives. The DBE program applies to airport and surface transportation, highway, transit, and aviation. The DBE program has been enacted by Congress to address historical discrimination against minority-owned firms in the transportation industry and to ensure that minority and women-owned businesses have a fair chance to participate in contracting opportunities made possible by federal financial assistance. The DBE program, with its rigid certification requirements, presents an excellent opportunity for a win-win for all parties. It is a success for VDOT and a success for the community. We want the residents of those communities to benefit from the public investment in that community. The majority of employment growth in the United States comes from small businesses. When small businesses are allowed to do contract work, it is an opportunity for people who might have been excluded from the relevant workforce to showcase their talents and skills, get trained, and work within the transportation industry to have more employment opportunities in the future. Advancing diversity and making money are not conflicting goals. It is good for business and good for society. DOT's DBE program is as relevant today as ever. To level the playing field in transportation for individuals, businesses, and communities of race, color, and gender. Our country suffers when talented people who have new ideas and who want to work hard are denied the opportunity to compete because of their ethnic background, race, or gender. And that is why there is a continued need for the Disadvantaged Business Program, a need to ensure that small businesses can compete fairly for federal-funded transportation-related projects. The DBE program, independent of inherent challenges and the nature that comes with those challenges, has provided opportunities for minorities and women-owned small businesses and other contractors to participate in an arena that has historically not seen such participation. It has allowed people to create jobs and give their employees a quality of life, which they would not have been able to do so before the DBE program. So, independent of all the challenges, the right part of the program is access. Access to many construction projects that use governmental money that will have a requirement with a designated percentage of the total contract values awarded, making sure they're awarded to the DBEs. This allows access to DBE businesses that may not have been able to compete on price with larger operations to win contracts on projects. In addition to the financial benefit, contacts are made with respective industries that may lead to additional work. It's about people, it's about jobs, and too often we forget that our industry golden nuggets are the people who participate in the DBE program, our small businesses, and the thousands upon thousands of people they employ. Oftentimes we forget that the faces behind the businesses also want to leave a legacy for their children, grandchildren, and for generations yet born. In closing, the success of DOT's DBE program depends on the rich diversity, skills, and talents of our DBEs. VDOT as an agency will continue to serve as a model DBE program to ensure that minority and women-owned businesses have a fair opportunity to participate in contracting opportunities at VDOT. Therefore, we're committed to championing and strengthening our DBE program. It is the real life stories of discrimination from minority and women business owners that are vital to assisting courts, policymakers such as yourselves and the public to understand the need to preserve and improve the government DBE program that helped to drive equality and inclusiveness within the USDOT DBE program. Again, I'm honored and thank you so much for your time and consideration.